हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल ऑफ थ्री हिंज्ड आर्च। क्वेश्चन इज रिटन एज अ थ्री हिंज्ड पैराबोलिक आर्च हैविंग अ स्पान ऑफ 20 मीटर एंड अ राइज ऑफ 5 मीटर कैरीज अ पॉइंट लोड ऑफ 10 किलोन्यूटन एट क्वार्टर स्पान फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एंड एज शोन इन द फिगर। Now here a 10 kN load is shown whose distance is 5 meter from support L. The resultant reaction at the left support and its inclination with the horizontal R respectively. Now we need to calculate the resultant reaction at the left support L and its inclination with the horizontal. Okay. Now for solving this we need to take some values as VL in the vertical direction at support L as well as HL at the support L. Similarly, VR in the vertical direction at support R and HR in the horizontal direction at support R. Now, we need to use the equilibrium condition. The first equilibrium condition will be equals to net summation of all the forces in the vertical direction equals to zero. So it will be equals to VL plus VR will be equals to 10 kN. That is the first equation. Now we will use the second equilibrium condition as moment about R will be equals to zero. Now by taking the moment about R, it will becomes VL into 20, positive sign is because of clockwise moment, minus 10 into 15 because of point load. We had taken 10 into 15 and negative sign is because of anti-clockwise moment. So it will be equals to 0. Now from this we will get the VL value as 7.5 kN. Now from equation first we will get VR value as 2.5 kN. So in this way we had determined the VL and VR value. Now we will go for the determination of horizontal reaction. Now we will use the third equilibrium condition, that is summation of all the forces in the horizontal direction will be equals to zero. So HL will be equals to HR. Okay, now that is the second equation. Now we want to use another equation here, that is the additional equilibrium equation, that is moment about S will be equals to zero, that is the internal hinge present at the crown. So we will take the moment from the support L and it will be equals to 7.5 into L due to VL reaction minus 10 into 5 due to point load minus H into 5 due to horizontal reaction, or we can say that HL into 5 due to horizontal reaction, and it will be equals to 0. Now we will calculate the value of HL from this equation, which will be equals to 5 kN. Now from equation second, if HL will be equals to 5 kN acting in the rightward direction, then HR will be equals to 5 kN acting in the leftward direction, because both are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. Okay, now we had calculated all the support reaction. Now we are going to calculate the resultant reaction at the left support L. Now for resultant reaction we need to use the equation, that is R will be equals to under root of HL square plus VL square. Now putting the value of HL and VL here, we will have 5 square plus 7.5 square. It will be equals to 9.01 kN. That will be the resultant reaction acting at the left support L. That is the resultant reaction. Now we need to calculate the inclination of this resultant from the horizontal. It means that we need to calculate the inclination of the resultant r from the horizontal, and it will be theta. Now the horizontal will be 5 and the vertical will be equals to 7.5. Now for finding theta, we have the equation, that is tan theta is equals to 7.5 divided by 5, that is perpendicular upon base. Now from this we will get the theta, that is tan inverse 7.5 divided by 5, and it will be equals to 56.31 degree. So we had calculated the resultant reaction acting at left support L, which will be equals to 9.01 kilonewton, and its inclination with the horizontal, which will be equals to 56.31 degree. That is all about this question. Thank you very much, students.